men in their late 30s and early 40s are the least happy of all of us.
Oh, yeah, that's true.
Whether it's that they're mourning the passing of their prime, understandable for all of us, or struggling to cope with the demands of a job and a young family, men aged 35 to 44 invariably hit a midlife crisis when their happiness level plunges lower than at any other age. It makes them the least satisfied members of society, scoring well below teenagers, the elderly, and women of all ages. They haven't lived to know what misery is.
Yeah, you haven't been alive long enough.
Yes.
No, I'm serious. That's one of the big things, reason kids kill themselves. They are betrayed by a lover, and the pain goes on and on and on for weeks, and it just doesn't seem it'll stop. So they end it all. It's like having a terminal cancer to them.
This is kids, you say?
Yeah, teenagers between 14 and 18.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, the first betrayal by the first person is so traumatic, and they have nothing to judge it against. Well, in my case, I've been divorced 3 times. It didn't kill me the last time. I might as well do it again.
You know, I hate to sound, I don't know, like I know anything.
Right.
I went through a lot when I was a kid. My parents were both sick, and I took care of them. And you might go through a lot as a teenager, but I always called it adding facets. I know this sounds corny, but it makes sense if you think about it. Adding facets to the diamond. It makes you interesting, and it also makes you more capable to deal with discomfort,
yes,
and obstacles in your life as you get older.
I agree 1,000%. Yeah, Joanna is a very independent person because she was raised by a couple of nuts in a very bizarre home. So she survived, but it makes you independent and strong and not a little flower that's going to wilt at the first sign of a problem.
Sure. And people who were raised in a relatively comfortable environment, who had everything for them, and they were spoiled, and I envied them. You know, once they got to be in their 20s and 30s, you know, as soon as something happened, whether it was an unrequited love or a divorce or, you know, somebody got sick, they freak out. They can hardly go on.
Yes. That's,
you know? And yeah. you get... Life never stays happy. Things always happen.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, you will always run into problems in life. And if you get, the only thing you say is you get used to these things. And the younger you get used to them, the more you're able to handle them when you get older. It doesn't make them any easier.
No, it just becomes relative. You know, everything's relative then.
Yeah.
Yeah, going through the Army, getting drafted, and going through basic training and surviving, almost getting sent to Vietnam about 3 times. After I got out of the Army, everything seemed to be real minor. Every problem seemed to be, no problem.
I'll bet a lot of, you know, our soldiers, men and women coming back from Iraq and Afghanistan are thinking the same thing right now.
Yeah, geez, I got laid off. At least I still have both my legs. That's good.
Exactly. Yeah. I was just thinking about that. You know, we have so many different, you know, there's tragedies, not just the deaths, but the missing limbs.
Oh, God, horrible, yeah. That's exactly what it does. There's my favorite general. I'm writing a book for women, and the general I quote is Thucydides. I might not be saying it quite right. But his quote is in all my books, and he says, "All men are much the same. He is best is he who is trained in the severest school." And what he means by that is generals whoop your basic trainees, and the ones who can't take it will be gone, and the ones who survive will be better than the enemy.
Well, it's kind of survival of the, I guess.
Yes, it is.
Yeah.
But you stress people, and like we were saying, it doesn't. Then the stress that you face in the future isn't nearly so frightening. You've already been through basic training, so this combat stuff is tough, but it's not nearly as bad as it would have seemed if you had never been in any, even mock combat, so.
They rated their carefree teenage years between the ages of 16 and 24, so that's a little more than teenage years, as one of, if not the happiest period of their lives.
Right, that's true.
I can understand that.
It is. The testosterone is as high as it's ever going to get.
You know, your testosterone is high. This is for a guy.
Mm-hmm.
You know enough about the world to get around independently, but you don't know enough about the world to be upset about its inevitable decline.
Mm-hmm.
But halfway through their career, satisfaction levels dipped to a low, only rising again once they crested to retirement age. The report found that women are less happy in their teens than men. Women said their worst years were between the ages of 25 and 34, when most women are coping with young children. Got steadily better as they got older, reaching a peak satisfaction over the age of 65.
Yeah, that corresponds with everything in the therapy business, every single bit of it.
So you're saying that, you know, you're happy in your teenage years, then the happiness goes down, and you're happy again at the age of 65. I had mentioned before we brought you on the air, Don, that maybe that, I don't know. I mean, when people reach their 60s, is there the acceptance, the inevitability of the decline of aging and mortality? Is that what it is?
It's that combined with there's not much life can throw at you haven't seen before. And my grandmother was 86 when she died, and I would say from 70 to 86, she was the most relaxed, accepting person I'd ever seen and have ever seen, except other older women who have made peace with the world, and they're at peace with the world, and nothing is a big deal anymore. Everything's relaxed. To her, the Korean War was, well, we went through World War II. This will be over someday.
Mm-hmm. Researchers found that most people rated, when it applied, their time at college as the best years of their lives.
Hear, hear.
Mostly followed by their retirement years. Call me crazy, but I think we then should combine them.
Yeah, send old people to college.
Send old people to college and let them be happy.
Yeah, nothing but wall-to-wall beer parties until you die.
Now, if we could do that as part of our health care.
That's the kind of socialism I'm in favor of.
No, I mean, think about it.
Give me my Social Security between 14 and 22, and you can keep it later. I'll party now.
So it'd be great to have college fantasy camp. And for people in their midlives or later lives, just recreate the college experience, even if you've never been to college.
Well, yeah, I agree, because those were my best years. I mean, that was just one never-ending party, and there were more women per square inch than I'd ever seen in my life. It was just a smorgasbord of life.
Put them in a dorm, and, you know, midnight, there's a ruckus in the hallway, and it's cheerleaders having mattress fights. Half-dressed with a beer and a pillowcase full of, munchies.
Uh-huh.
And come on! So we have 60 seconds for you, Don, to give us the answers and tell us how to be happy.
Oh, I do have some good advice for this. This is difficult. It's so simple, it's difficult. Let me put it that way. I was watching a video of Kurt Vonnegut just before he died doing an interview, and they were asking him about this and that, and he said, well, I would say that character is based on my uncle so-and-so, who taught me it's very important that most of us don't take a time to enjoy the few moments when we are happy. One day we were sitting in the shade sipping lemonade on a hot day, and he said to me, I was about 12 at the time, and he said to me, how could it get any better than this? And that's most of us what we do. We dwell on the negative. We forget about the very simple moments that make us happy or enjoyable. And it's difficult to shift gears and get into the present and enjoy the sun on your face or the wind in your hair, or that song you love playing on the radio and how good it makes you feel. And my particular way of doing this is when I sit down in my office in the morning, I have a big window, I look out, and I look at the trees and the sun shining on the trees or the rain hitting the trees, and I sip that first cup of coffee and I go, God, how could it get any better than this?
To enjoy it while you can.
Yeah, because the rain will fall.
Play air guitar where you can still hear the music.
That's good advice.
That's it. We have to run. Thanks a lot. We'll talk to you next week.
Okay, Brian. I enjoyed it as always.
I enjoyed it here, too. Thanks.